Hello, I'm Professor Mimi Tang from the Murdoch Children's Research Institute in Melbourne, Australia. In this video, I will present key findings from the PPOIT3 long-term study, reporting two-year post-treatment outcomes following peanut immunotherapy in this month's Allergy Journal. The PPOIT-LT post-treatment follow-on study is a continuation of the PPOIT3 randomized trial. In the randomized trial, 201 children with peanut allergy were randomized to receive high dose peanut OIT or a combination probiotic peanut OIT or placebo. All children received treatment for 18 months. At the end of this time, two challenges were completed to assess and establish clinical allergy status following treatment. Both challenges were to a cumulative 5 gram amount of peanut protein. The first challenge completed immediately after treatment was discontinued, and the second challenge performed 8 weeks post-treatment. If children passed both challenges, they were classified as being in clinical remission and were instructed to eat peanut freely. Children who passed the first challenge but failed the second challenge were classified as fully desensitized and instructed to continue on 1 to 2 peanuts a day in order to maintain their desensitization status. Children who failed the first challenge, irrespective of any incremental increases in reaction threshold, were classified as allergic and instructed to continue with strict peanut avoidance. All children were followed prospectively to 2 years post-treatment, monitoring peanut intake, reactions to peanut, and quality of life. 151 of 176 eligible children enrolled in the long-term follow-on study. The long-term follow-on study had two study aims. Firstly, comparison of long-term outcomes by clinical allergy status, that is, remission, desensitization without remission, or persistent allergy. The second study aim was comparison of long-term outcomes by treatment group, that is, high-dose peanut oral immunotherapy or probiotic peanut oral immunotherapy combination or placebo. Measures included peanut ingestion, reactions, and health-related quality of life. This slide shows findings by clinical allergy status group. Here you see the proportion of patients who reported reactions and the proportion of patients who reported rescue epinephrine use. At both 1 year and 2 years post-treatment, remission participants were half as likely to have reactions compared with desensitized participants. Use of rescue epinephrine reduced in the remission group, but were similar in year one and year two for the desensitized participants. This slide shows severity of reactions in the first and second year post-treatment for the three clinical allergy status groups. As you can see, remission patients experienced substantial 53% reduction in the number of reactions, and more importantly, reported no severe or moderate reactions and no rescue epinephrine use in the second year post-treatment. In comparison, desensitized patients reported a modest 11% reduction in the number of reactions and continued to experience both moderate and severe reactions, as well as requiring epinephrine for some reactions. This slide shows the change in quality of life from baseline in the three clinical groups. The validated food allergy quality of life questionnaire was used to assess quality of life. A reduced score indicates improved quality of life. As you can see, the remission group in blue had clinically meaningful improvement in quality of life and statistically significant improvement compared with both desensitized or allergic patients. The degree of improvement well exceeded the minimum clinically important difference of -0.45. In contrast, desensitized patients did not experience improved quality of life at any time point compared with the allergic group. Turning to comparison of long-term outcomes by treatment group, both the active treatments, high-dose peanut OIT and the combination probiotic peanut OIT groups reported significantly improved quality of life compared with placebo at both 1 and 2 years post-treatment. Improvements in quality of life were substantial, exceeding the minimum clinically important difference of 0.45. These improvements in quality of life were reported despite more reactions occurring in both the peanut OIT and probiotic peanut OIT groups compared to placebo. But in all groups, reactions reduced over time, with the majority being mild and low rates of rescue epinephrine use. In summary, comparison of long-term outcomes by clinical allergy status following treatment showed that remission is the optimal outcome for patients compared to only being desensitized or remaining allergic. Remission participants had fewer and milder allergic reactions to peanut with no requirement for rescue epinephrine in the second year post-treatment, compared to desensitized patients who continued to have reactions that were moderate or severe and required rescue epinephrine use. Most importantly, remission participants experienced substantially better quality of life compared with both the desensitized or allergic participants. In comparison of long-term outcomes by treatment group, both the high-dose peanut OIT and the combination probiotic peanut OIT provided sustained improvement in quality of life compared to placebo. Thank you.